All right, the next set of examples I want to do, keep that same paper, involve integrals of products of sines and cosines. Let's start with the integral of sine of 5x times cosine of 4x. Now you actually can do this one by parts. It's one where you have to do it by parts twice, and then you have to solve for the integral you want to find. It's a bit tricky. I'd actually never done it until you were working on your mini exam here. It was the first time I tried it that way. I'm going to show you what I did. Do not write down what I show you here. I'll post the video. You can take a screenshot of the video if you like. There it is in all its glory. Let u equal sine 5x, v prime be cos 4x, uv minus the integral of v times u prime. And then I did my parts again, and I solved for the integral I wanted to know, and I ultimately got that. Yikes, okay, you can, yeah. Can I get it on one page? Yeah, okay, close enough. If you're interested, you can look at it when I post the video. That's not the way I want you to do that kind of problem for your homework. There will be a homework assignment due Monday that is just more integrals. Instead, I want you to get a little practice with the table in the back of the book. Or since it's, you have loose leaf in the back of your loose leaf pages. In the back of the book, there's a table of differentiation formulas. There's a short table of indefinite integrals. By short, they mean a couple pages. You can make books of indefinite integrals. And the one that applies here is number 12, because I'm integrating sine of 5x times cosine of 4x. So this is the one that applies. Is that big enough? Sine of 5x times cosine of 4x. In other words, a is 5 and b is 4. And so you just plug those numbers in there. Plug in a equals 5 and b equals 4 into this to get the answer. Let's see if we get the same answer that I got with integration by parts. So again, I'm coming back here and I'm going to use a is 5 and b is 4. I'll just rewrite what the back of the book says that says this is 1 over b squared minus a squared times in parentheses b sine ax times sine bx plus a cos ax cos bx. Of course, you could not use this formula if a and b were equal because you'd be dividing by 0. Okay, not something you have to know for the gateway, by the way. This is not something you need to know for the gateway, but it does come up sometimes in some applications. So now I'll use this with a equal to 5 and b equal to 4. So I'll get 1 over b squared is 16, a squared is 25, b is 4, a is 5. Just plug the numbers in. And then it probably is worth going ahead and simplifying a little bit. That's the same as negative 1/9 for the greater sake, right? And by the way, when you do these problems, it's from section 7.3. Do use the table in the back of the book. That's what they want you to do. And for the greater sake, so that they see the same answer, go ahead and use those tables. Distribute the negative 1/9 through the parentheses. 4 times negative 1/9 is negative 4/9. So I get negative 4/9. Sine 5x, sine 4x, and then a minus 5/9 cos 5x, cos 4x, plus c. Is that the same thing I got while you were working on your mini exam? Try to remember it here, negative 4 ninths sine 5x, sine 4x, minus 5 ninths, cos 5x, cos 4x, plus c. Guess what? Same thing. Yeah, there's my integration by parts stuff. I got the same answer. I was so happy. Okay, I was afraid I was going to get the wrong answer. Whoops. Okay, when you do section 7.3, though, the point is to use the tables in the back of the book. So use them. Okay, get a little practice. So that's the only way these problems can be done with either integration by parts or tables. Actually, no. Another way you could do it is with a trigonometric identity. In particular, one of these two you could use, and essentially this one here. We'll see where I can't highlight it. See where the cursor is here? Oh, there we go. I could use that one and divide both sides by two. Sine theta times cos, that other Greek letter is a phi. If I divide by two is 1/2 sine of theta plus phi plus 1/2 sine of theta minus phi. What are theta and phi? Well, for this problem, they are, where is it? They are 5x and 4x. So theta plus phi is going to be 5x plus 4x is 9x. And theta minus phi is going to be 5x minus 4x is just x. That would be an easier way to go, actually. Producing a simpler looking answer, actually. If I believe that formula on Wikipedia, assuming nobody's been trying to trick us on Wikipedia. I could replace sine x for cos sine 5x cos 4x with 1/2 sine 9x. Was it plus? I think it was plus. Plus 1/2 sine x. According to Wikipedia, those two functions are equal. Yeah, it's right. Amazingly, it's not obvious in the least, right? But that happens in trigonometry, that you often have things that look different are actually the same. Trigonometric identities come into play there. And that's an easier integral to do. This would be negative 1/18 cos 9x minus 1/2 cos x plus c. The answer looks completely different too, but they should be equivalent. They should be the same. Actually, these two functions without the c could differ by a constant because the c effectively could be different, but I believe they are the same. They don't look like they're the same, but they are. And in fact, if you use Mathematica here, well, if you do the integral, Mathematica does it the last way that I just did. Yep, there's the same answer I just wrote down, which you can differentiate to get something that doesn't look like our answer, but actually is. And you can differentiate the one we got with the table and get the original integrand. Evidently, these two functions, this one and this one, the original integrand, should be the same. If I plot them both, I should only see one graph. It's because of the same function. I mean, if I want a little extra confirmation, maybe I should add 0.1 to one of them. Yeah, there's two functions being graphed. They just happen to be the same function. They look different, but they're the same. Amazing. So with trigonometric functions, things can get a little funny as far as checking answers go because of all the trigonometric identities out there.